probably kind of stalling here, and that will be one of the features that might keep whatever is Eta at that point, probably a tropical storm by then, perhaps confined to the eastern Gulf of Mexico. So the upper level winds along with that surface front are going to guide it, it looks like, to the east, although there have been a few indications that if Eta weakens a lot, it might not be guided so much by these features that we've been talking about, the trough of low pressure, this southwest flow, and this high pressure building over to the southwest in the Gulf of Mexico. So the official National Hurricane Center forecast still has that movement to the north part of Florida, really on the probably eastern side of the Florida panhandle, but there is some uncertainty. A few things that I was pointing out earlier, all this dry air in the reds and oranges, that's really dry air, and it is beginning to get into the circulation here, so that's why Eta has weakened as we got into the past few hours. Its winds now down to 50 miles per hour, not showing a really symmetric look with all of the rain pretty much displaced, especially over to the northeast. And again, here's the forecast with a probably maybe briefly strengthening storm, but then eventually weakening system as it moves off to the north. So just to give you an idea, this is the European model going just exactly with that kind of setup. It has it moving to the north and then to the northeast. But just to give you an idea, the GFS has it weakening a lot, hovering for a while in the eastern Gulf, and then once it begins to kind of fall apart, bring some of the moisture over toward Louisiana. And we've seen a big kind of disagreement with the models. Some of these keeping it much weaker are letting it drift a bit farther west, not so much guided by those stronger upper level features. And then a lot still do bring it off to the north and northeast. So a little bit of some uncertainty in the long range forecast. I think for us, no big impacts expected right now, but if the GFS or some other models do play out like that, it might bring us some rain this weekend, maybe a couple of inches. So we'll watch it for sure. At this point, we'll have to wait and see. There's another wave that might develop in the Caribbean, and this one is non-tropical out way in the Atlantic, but this one might take on some tropical characteristics and could become Theta quite soon. I don't want to talk about Theta. Hopefully we don't have to talk much about it. That one's going to stay away. That one in the Caribbean, it looks like, will be guided towards Central America. So we'll track that one too. Our 7-day forecast keeps us pretty warm. Next week, we may get a stronger cold front. And again, we'll watch everything with Theta.